Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you step by step how to start a legal blog. So what we're going to cover today is what exactly is a legal blog. I'm going to provide a few examples for you. I'm going to show you and tell you why you need to pick a niche and then how to niche down within that niche so that you can start getting traffic. After that, we're going to talk a little bit about something called web hosting, why you need it and how you can get it, and how you can get a free domain name for the first year. After that, we're going to install WordPress. We're going to install both a free and premium WordPress theme. After that, we're going to make some changes that you absolutely have to make so that your website can start getting traffic. And then I'm going to help you start writing. After that, we're going to talk about different ways that you can make money with your blog and why you need to share your content on social media in the very beginning. And then we're going to address about how many blog posts you should write before you make a decision one way or another. Be sure to check out the first three links in the description, as those will be the links that I refer to throughout this video. All right, first things first, what is a legal blog? A legal blog is simply a blog where you're answering questions with regard to legal practices. Now, this is going to be very important when you pick a niche, is you need to determine who you're talking to, because people are coming to the internet and they're asking questions about legal stuff. Maybe they're looking for a divorce attorney. Maybe they're looking for civil liability, criminal liability, things of that nature. You need to figure out if you are talking to the average person that knows absolutely nothing about legal jargon, or if you're talking to someone that maybe has a law degree or a law license to practice law. One thing that you want to consider when you're picking a niche within the legal niche is, are you going to be talking about corporate law? Are you talking about legal operations, legal technology? As I mentioned, who is your target audience? That's going to be very important when you get up and running. And let me just give you an example here. All right, so here's an example of a website that does a pretty good job. Now, this website's fairly large, and so they're able to cover a multitude of topics. This website's called AboveTheLaw.com. Now, when you're first getting started with your website, I recommend that you focus on one niche. If you're going to be talking about criminal trial, focus on that. Because this website's so large and it's been around for such a long time, they're able to cover a wide range of topics. But in the very beginning, if you have no domain authority, you have no credibility, focus on one niche and then go from there. One way to find a niche, if you're not really sure, is to take the domain name, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. We'll take the domain name of a website that you want to emulate or you want to model your website after. You can put it right into this website called Ahrefs. It is a website that can help you find keywords. And so what we're going to do is we're just going to put that domain name right there, hit enter, and then it's actually going to give us a bunch of keywords that they already rank for. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on organic keywords. It says they have about 182,000 of them. And right here in the middle, a keyword difficulty, this is a scale of 0 to 100. The closer to 100, the more difficult it would be for a website to rank. Now, what I recommend that you do, since you're going to be a brand new website, is change the keyword difficulty to 5 or less. And when you do that, you're going to see very niche down topics that you could potentially write on. So did Hobby Lobby fire employees by email? Could be something that you write on if you're talking about different cases. Another thing you could write on is previous cases, people that were on death row and were exonerated. There's a lot of opportunity out here, but I recommend that you pick a niche and then niche down. We're going to refer to these keywords later on in this video. So keep these keywords in mind. So the next step is to go ahead and get web hosting. So web hosting is important and required so that your website can be seen on the internet. What you're going to do is you're going to work with a web hosting provider. You're going to rent hard drive space, which is called a server, so that your website can be seen around the internet. Now, the first link in the description is probably the best web hosting company for beginners. They make it really easy to get up and running. In fact, when you click that first link and you get started today, you'll actually get a domain name for free. And a domain name is simply a name that humans refer to your website by. AboveTheLaw.com is the domain name for this website. And then you can get your domain name for free for the first year. In fact, I'm going to walk you through the steps right now, how to get web hosting and set up a domain name step by step. It only takes about 10 minutes, but it's really easy. And we're going to go ahead and take care of that right now. When you click that link, you'll be taken to this website where you'll go ahead and click Get Started. What I recommend is to click the first one on the far left, the basic plan, if you're just getting started with a website. As you can see, there are a number of options, but click that, click select, and then move on. Here you're going to create a domain name. If you have one in mind, you can type it in here like you see that I do. what I recommend is try and find a domain name that's going to be related to your niche. Now, what I do is I type in a domain name that I know is already taken. When it's taken, you're going to get this error. What you can then do is go back and try different domains. Now, make sure, again, you want to pick one that's related to your niche. Click Next, and then you're going to see a green box that says that it's approved. The next step is simply to go through and enter in your contact information. Make sure that you, when you scroll down here, make sure that you leave all of the settings on. But again, enter in your contact information. The settings right here where it says domain privacy, leave all of this checked. If you don't leave it checked, you're going to get people reaching out to you, spamming you, emailing you, trying to get you to sign up for web hosting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and sign up and then jump back to you once I sign on and move to the next step. All right, so I have signed up and I'm going to go ahead and set up my website initially. Just create a simple username and password, make sure it meets the requirements there, and then move on. Make sure that you write it down too. Write it down in a safe spot so that you have it and you remember it, because it can be a pain to go ahead and get everything back. You're gonna have to enter in like some vital information, but just make sure that you write it down. It's really easy and really simple. Now, one thing that I do wanna note is that this part is not sped up at all. This is actual real time, and you can see that you'll go from absolutely nothing to a complete website in less than probably 10 minutes. And once you click submit, you're going to move on to the next step where you get to log in. Here is where you're actually going to start creating your WordPress website. Now, the great thing is Bluehost really does everything for you, and it's really simple. So again, I'm not speeding this up at all, and I want you to see what it really takes to create a website. Bluehost is going to do a little bit of work in the background for you, and we're just going to actually click on skip this step. This one, first one I clicked on, start a blog, but for the next step, just click skip because we know what we're doing, and I'm actually going to tell you what to do so that we can get up and running. Click get started right here on the left hand side and then move on. Just click skip here and click skip here. And then just pick the first one in the far left. Make sure that you're picking a free theme because they'll charge you. They have both free and premium themes, which I'll talk about in just a moment. So right now, it's actually creating your WordPress website. In just a few moments, you're going to click on log in to WordPress on the right-hand side there. You'll see it in just a second. And then we can actually start looking at some basic configurations. All right, so we click log in, and now we actually have a WordPress website. What may need to happen is you may need to click refresh a few times to get it to work, but now we have our website, as you can see. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to log in and delete a few plugins, because right now it has the coming soon, and so if someone tried to get to your website at this moment, it's going to say coming soon to them, even though we can see it. This is what your WordPress website looks like, but for everyone else outside of your network, it's going to say coming soon. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down to plugins eventually, and we're going to delete some of the plugins that we don't need. Now, I talk a little bit about plugins later on, but plugins add additional features and functionality. We are going to deactivate the Bluehost as well as the other plugins that are already activated, and then we can go through and make the necessary changes, which I'll cover in just a moment. So we're going to deactivate them and then delete them. Now, you want to make sure that you only have the plugins that you're using on your website. The more plugins you have, the slower your website's going to respond and function, and you're going to lose out on ranking. So make sure you have a lean setup, very few plugins, and then move on. As you can see right now, I'm just simply deleting some stuff that you don't need. If you want to, you could keep them, but obviously if you're just getting started, you don't need this other stuff. What's more important is the themes that we're going to talk about in just a moment, as well as getting writing. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete those, deactivate them. And then we're actually going to start moving on to settings, which you see right here. All right, so let's go ahead and make some changes that we absolutely have to make so that you can start getting traffic. The first thing that you want to do is you want to change your site title. Your site title is going to be the title of your website. You can make this basically your domain name. For example, my domain name is Web Hosting Rewind, and you can see that's my site title. And then the tagline is basically what your website's all about in a very succinct manner. As you can see here, mine says, get the latest news and info on all things web hosting. What you want to do is make sure that yours is relevant to your niche. For example, if you are creating content about makeup, you can say, come here for the latest tips and tricks for all things makeup. Next, you want to make sure that your WordPress address is HTTPS and not HTTP. Make sure your site address is HTTPS as well. And then the administration email should automatically be set. Uncheck the membership so that anyone can register. Make sure that this is unchecked. If we scroll down here, you want to change your time zone to your time zone. There are all sorts of them here. Next, you want to make sure that you have your date format set to the way you want, and then go ahead and click save. If we go down to writing, there isn't anything in writing that we need to change. After that, we're going to go to reading. In reading, very important, you want to make sure that your homepage displays to your latest post. That's the first thing. And the second one is you want to make sure that your search engine visibility is unchecked. Do not check this. Discourage search engines from indexing this site. You do not want this, because if this is checked, people aren't going to be able to find your website, and everything that we do after this is going to be a waste. So go ahead and click save. This should be unchecked. Next, if we go down to discussion, there really isn't anything that we need to change here. Media, we can leave this as is, and then permalinks is going to be really important. Right now, your permalinks are set to plain. You want to change it to post name. This is done for search engine optimization. What's going to happen is when we create a new blog post, we are going to make it so that it's search engine optimized. We're going to use the keyword in our title, and that keyword is going to show up right here as well. And this is called search engine optimization. Make sure that it's set to post name, and then go ahead and click save. And really, that's everything that you need to do to make sure that you start getting traffic. All right, so now that we've installed WordPress, we've installed a free WordPress theme. I'm going to show you how to get a premium one in just a second. We've made some changes to our website so that we can eventually start getting traffic. Now, right now you have a free basic theme. That theme has no features, no functionality. It's very average looking. What I recommend that you do is get yourself a premium WordPress theme. For example, this website right here has probably a premium WordPress theme. It has additional features and functionality. You can see the images are larger, and it's really designed to get people to click and read through. And you can get a premium WordPress theme by clicking the second link in the description. When you click that second link, it'll take you to this website. And what you're going to do is you might want to type in legal, or you can type in law, or you can type in like constitutional law, for example. And we're just going to click on this one right here, and we're going to see what pops up. As you can see here, there are a few WordPress themes that you could purchase and download that are geared towards legalities or a legal website. And so what you're going to do is you're going to go through, spend about 10 minutes and find one that you like. Then you're going to press this button and add it to your cart. Once you add it to your cart, you're going to pay and then download. You're going to download a zip file. What you're going to do next is unpack that zip file, and there's going to be a second zip file. We're going to take that second zip file, and we're actually going to install it into our WordPress dashboard. And to do that, we're going to go back over to WordPress. We're going to go to Appearance and click on Themes. When we click on Themes, we're going to click on Add New, and then we are going to click on Upload Theme. When we click on Upload Theme, we're either going to drag and drop that second zip file right here, or we can manually find it by clicking on Choose File. Regardless of the method, you're going to click on Install Now and then Activate, and then you're going to have a brand new updated website that looks much better than the standard template. So if we jump back over here, the next step is starting to write. Now, I get three questions when it comes to writing. How long should my blog post be? How do I start writing? And how many blog posts should I write? And so let's go ahead and take care of two of those right now. To start writing, we're simply going to go up to post. We're going to click on add new. And then we're going to grab our keyword that we had in the previous step. So did Hobby Lobby fire employees by email? We're going to copy this. This is our keyword that we want to rank for. People are coming to the internet and they're searching about this Hobby Lobby firing employees. And so we are going to put this at the front end of our title. This title is the title that's going to show up in search engines when people are asking this question, because people are asking this exact question and we want to show up in search engines. So what we're going to do, we're simply just going to make sure that this is cleaned up just a little bit, and we have our keyword. And then the next step is, how do I start writing and how long should my blog post be? And really, the answer to how long your blog post should be depends on the question that's being asked. It depends on what your competitors are doing, and it really depends on how long it takes you to answer the question. Your blog post should only be as long as it needs to be and not a sentence longer. And to get an idea of how long your blog post should be, we're just going to paste in our keyword here, and we are going to look at this first result. And when we look at the first result, we're just going to do a quick keyword count. If I had to guess here, that's probably about, we'll say probably about 1,200 words. So if we right click here, go word counter. Okay, it's only 1,000 words, 936 words. What I'd probably do is I'd probably write about a 1,500-word blog post thoroughly answering this question. And one way to make sure that you are answering the question is to skim through and see if they missed anything. Is there an important point that they did not add? Has new information been released since this blog post has been uploaded? And one way to help you write faster and better is simply to do a 10-minute brainstorming session. And in that 10-minute brainstorming session, we're simply going to enter in six writing prompts. So we're going to do who, what, when, where, why, and how. And what you're going to do is you're going to take about 10 or 15 minutes and just ask and answer questions with regard to your keyword and your writing prompt. So we could say, when was the email received? When was the email received? And when you are doing this, when you're doing your brainstorming session, it's not important that you get the word spelled correctly. What is important is to get your ideas down on paper so that you can formulate a good blog post. You can say, why did employees receive email? And just go through and ask yourself questions about your keyword and then use the writing prompts. Now, a ton of questions will come up. Write them all down. And what you're going to do after your 15-minute brainstorming session is you're simply going to just delete the ones that don't make any sense and keep the ones that are relevant to your question. The ones that you keep, you're simply going to turn these into H2s, which are headings, and then you're going to answer the question. The employees first received the emails on January 18th, or whatever the answer is. And so what you're going to do is you're simply just going to answer the questions and fill out your blog post. And once you're done, you're going to click on publish. When you click on publish, it is going to be ready for the world to see, hear, read, and react to. Now that we have that, the next step is to figure out some ways to make money. We'll go here like that. You can see make money. Now there are a number of ways to make money with your website. One of the easiest ways to make money is simply to place ads right on your website. Now if I'm looking at this, there's already three ads that I see. This one right here, this one at the very bottom, and this one on the right here. Now, running ads or placing ads right on your website is really easy and can be done automatically. You can start with working with a company like Google AdSense. And once you go through this process, the process takes about 15 minutes to get started, you can place ads right on your website. The only drawback to Google AdSense is they do not pay very much. You will get pennies on the dollar for placing ads with Google AdSense. However, once you start getting some real significant traffic, you can actually upgrade or move on to premium ad networks. There's Ezoic, there's Media.net, there's AdThrive. There's a ton of premium ad networks out there, and they'll actually pay you a little bit more money. So consider that when you are creating your content. But in addition to placing ads, you can also do affiliate marketing. Now, affiliate marketing is simply recommending or selling other people's products and services. For example, you could be an affiliate for the Rocket Lawyer affiliate program, and people are going through reading your blog, they'll click on your affiliate links and make a purchase, you can earn a commission. Now, the key to affiliate marketing is recommending products that are in line or congruent with your target audience. If you are talking about lawyer, maybe they need some special form that you can point them in the right direction for, as long as it's relevant to your content, it is a good fit. It would not make sense for you to recommend basket weaving if your content is about divorce or divorce law. In addition to affiliate marketing, you can also sell your own physical and digital products. Maybe you have a consulting service where you are consulting corporate entities about their next steps, about maybe changing to an S corp or an LLC, and you want to sell that. Now you can actually sell that right on your blog or website with a few different plugins. Now that is outside the scope of this video, but that is an opportunity as well. Now that we've looked at a few different ways to make money, the next thing that you want to do is share your content on social media. The reason why you want to share your content on social media in the very beginning is because you will not be getting a lot of traffic from Google, at least initially. It will take time for Google to start sending significant traffic and help speed that process up and start getting, in order to start reaching the goals that you want, whether it's making money or, you know, getting your world views into the hands of many readers, I recommend that you share your content on social media. You can share it on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, LinkedIn, anywhere where your customers are. Now, it's just like the affiliate marketing aspect. You only share your content where people are interested. If there is a Facebook group full of corporate executives and they want to learn more information about law, that's where you share it. It would not make sense for you to share content about divorce proceedings on an MBA form. That would not make sense at all. And then finally, the question that I get the most is about how many blog posts should I write before I decide one way or another. In my opinion, you should set a goal of writing 50 blog posts. Now, 50 blog posts is a really good number because you show Google that you're serious. You actually will get better at writing. You'll have 50 keywords that are out there in the world working for you day and night. And so that's 50 opportunities to start ranking and start getting traffic. I think that you should write every day for 50 days or write every other day for 100 days until you get 50 blog posts up. That is a very good goal to set for yourself. Be sure to check out the three links in the description. The first one is for web hosting. The second one is for a premium WordPress theme. And then the third one is for a free affiliate marketing course. Be sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell. This video or any other video on this channel helps you out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.